Okay, we're going to be cutting two center felts. Now, we got two containers. These are the jacks for back here, and these are the jacks for here. So we'll take one of these, and let's just stick it in here. And I can see there's still a teeny bit of residue of the plastic on here from when we had to grind it. That's like extra quality control. They do now fit in there. Originally, they were a little bit too fat. I had to bring them in just a hair, and you can see there's still just a teeny bit of, there you go, the plastic there, like this. Okay, so we need to cut two little pieces. Now that's this stuff here. And I'm going to say that glasses now for the fine work. And I'm going to say that that's that. Now, I'm thinking I'd like a pair of tweezers. Okay. Now, let's get some. Let me get a rag with some water on it so I have something to wipe stuff off if it goes badly. You always want to have a little paper towel ready. The glue gets out of control or something happens that you're not happy with. Take a little bit of glue, not much. Okie dokie. Now, these have a curvature because they were in a roll, and I'd rather have the curvature facing the side of the wood than to have it the other way. So that one is going to get put in like that, and that one's going to get flipped over and put in like that. And that's important, because we're ready to lay the glue. You will have to lay glue both on the wood in here and on the felt, because otherwise it will not glue. You want to be precise with this. Get it pretty even. Okay, now verify I have a center pin jack here, and I know this is the part that I want to hit with glue. Freshened up my glue. Doesn't have to be a whole lot, just a little bit of glue. Mm-hmm. pressing it into position. I'm going to bring them up a hair, because pushing the jack in is going to take them down a hair. If you wiggle back and forth, it'll have a tendency to grab the stuff a little less. Jack needs to go in straight like this. We can peek. It is correct. Totally square, jack's in. Now you have to go like that to get to the other, to put stuff here. Now that, this will get this jack. Okay, and this is the one I've got to be careful because I don't have a lot of this stuff. So I'm looking at again, I'm trying to keep the curvatures against the wood. I need to be careful of this jack here. So my first thing is to come in into a fly. I'm gonna need a little bit more glue. I might as well do it now. Cover up your glue always. See this? I gotta come in here. Put a little bit of glue. Always wipe the excess off to get it up here. Or you can cut it off later too. Now, this one goes like this. That's pretty picky work, isn't it? Push that into there. So it's in a preset position. I realize this is kind of time consuming. very picky work. But we're not in any hurry. I can't say I mind this job, this particular one. I don't mind. Now, what you can do is you kind of push it down, see, and then you can reposition your felt back up again with the screwdriver so that it doesn't go into the hole too deep and presses over into position. Helping it to lie in position. What I've learned is you have to do that. You have to help the felt to get into its proper lay. And I wiggle back and forth a little bit. That key can dry. So let's make sure that, you know, these are lined up again nicely. I'm gonna go ahead and set this down somewhere where it's safe and can dry. And that's probably on the piano. That's number one. This is number two.